tau whakalofa, mai whakawelahi mahaki ki a Mutulo Osi, ha kuala liu mai ki a Tangata Pasifika, e tapu nei ko e whahi tapu vanga au Niue.
That's right, we're celebrating Niue Language Week, ha e tau tala hau tau tolu mai a Tangata Pasifika hei aho nei. Young Niueans do their bit to keep their language alive.
It is our obligation and duty to ensure that our mga au Niue, anga whakamotu survives.
How Vanuatu cover becomes so popular, there's not enough of it.
We are facing since last year a general shortage on the cover situation.
And Will Black, Nafi Lefono, talks about the challenges ahead.
Kind of my life flashed from my eyes kind of thing, you know, like, what am I going to do now? You know, how are my family going to cope?
But first, here's your Pacific News, brought to you by Susanna Talangi Gutenbio. Whakalofalahi atu, Susanna.
Whakalofalahi atu, Sena Fulava and Marama. A Pacific Islands health provider is being investigated by the Serious Fraud Office after allegations it misspent taxpayer money to fund overseas trips. The Pacific Island and Safety Prevention Project in West Auckland suddenly closed its doors earlier this month. The Ministry of Social Development has stopped funding and the project is now in liquidation. A new program designed to give school children the opportunity to create their own music video to help eliminate bullying was officially launched this week. The Pasifika Foundation worked with local Auckland schools to create songs and a music video to spread the anti-bullying message. It's all part of the AHA Music Mentoring Program, which TJ Tautua helps run. He says the project has been a long-term goal.
It's been 15 years in the making for me, particularly working in the government sector, in the youth sector, as well as the tertiary space, and using music, you know, maybe sort of 10-20% of the time to kind of either do a performance or, you know, or run some sort of small project. But now we've been able to develop a trust and actually use music at the forefront of our delivery.
The foundation already has schools lined up for another album release early next year. Changing attitudes towards people with disabilities is the aim behind a song and video launched in Wellington last night. Siva was written by musician and producer Pati Umanga, who's been confined to a wheelchair since a freak accident left him paralysed 10 years ago. The song was recorded with the help of his band Kumbasa.
This is about movement, it's about song, and being able to really know that those things are a part of you, but people outside of the disability sector, they don't seem to think that disabled people can do those kind of things, like actually dance or can sing or perform.
A member of 80s band The Holidaymakers, Umanga received support from the Ministries of Health, Social Development and ACC, as well as Disabled Persons Assembly for the song. And congratulations to Pacific Island Opera Group Sole Mio for their People's Choice nomination at this year's Vodafone Music Awards. Their nomination comes on the heels of the release late last week of their second album, On Another Note. The trio was up against some tough competition though, with Lord Standwalker and 660 also nominated. In sport, heavyweight boxer Lupe Soliei La'auli Joseph Parker is another step closer to a title shot after his win against journeyman Carly Meehan in the third round on Thursday night. Questions were raised over his ability to defeat Meehan, who had previously ended Shane Cameron's career. However, Parker proved too quick and fast for Meehan, taking down the 45-year-old in brutal fashion with a technical knockout. Parker will now focus on his next bout in December and begin planning a January bout in Samoa. And finally, she's better known as a spoken word poet, but now Samoan Grace Taylor's trying her hand as a playwright. Her first work is called My Own Darling and it opens at the Mangere Arts Centre tonight. John Utanga has the story.
From the tip of Mangafok.
She's written it.
I write words with stones in the mouth of a dormant volcano.
And she acts in it. My Own Darling is Grace Taylor's tribute to the city of Auckland.
It is exposing Auckland, really, that how I see it through my eyes. You meet five different characters and how their environment and their world impacts them. And there are underlying themes and voices of contradictions that exist in our community.
It's not a huge departure from the work she's done as a spoken word poet and a community artist, but it's very personal.
I've worked in the community a lot and I've, with the help of others, I've helped to build platforms for other artists and young, especially young Pacific voices. And this year I just really needed to take time to refuel, and to me refueling looks like feeding my creative energy and my creative bucket.
The cast includes experienced actor Fasitua Amosa and newcomer Gabby Solomona. A Pacific cast, also with a Pacific director.
The characters that Grace has created are so alive and so vivid that pretty much everyone who's been involved goes, I know that character. And that's the beauty of it, that you don't have to be from any one particular culture to see the world that we live in front of us and go, oh, I connect with that. And maybe next time I'll look at that situation a little bit differently.
Supported by the Auckland Theatre Company, the show runs until next Thursday night.
And our children. And that's your Pacific News. Back to you, Saina Fulava and Marama.